This week we're talking with Kirk Dewindt, who comes from Minnesota, and he's going to talk to us about dealing with injuries as an athlete and a trainer. Hey Spartans, this is Kevin Gillotti, and welcome to the Spartan Athlete. Kirk, I know that you're a trainer, and yep. I know that you deal with your own injuries, and you deal with some of your clients' injuries. Let's talk a little bit about the common injuries that you would see, and how you might treat some of those injuries, common injuries.
Sure. If we're going to talk endurance athletes specifically, most injuries are overuse, are repetitive, forward nature. So usually, and I can speak for myself with this unfortunately, our lateral and support system is typically weak. So we need to work adductors, abductors, those small finite controlling muscle groups which allow misalignments need to be corrected.
Okay.
So typically I start there.
Okay. In that vein, what would be the types of movements that a person at home could do?
Yeah, I would do a lot of what I would consider lateral leg movements, hip girdle strength, anything that's gonna work this region, because everything in my opinion either starts from the hip or it starts from the foot and comes up.
Okay.
So one, make sure you're in the right shoe.
Yes.
Two, make sure you're listening to your body, hard for us to do. And three, you wanna work on your hip stabilization. So anything where abducting, adducting, some hip flexor movements and some glute stimulation, like those things, I could get into specifics, but we need to work on our hip girdle because a lot of things stem from that.
Okay.
Yep.
Now, what about, let's talk about some upper strength, because we know that 90% of Spartan races and 90% of OCR races are going to be grip intensive, strength intensive, upper body intensive.
Yep.
Somebody recently asked me a question. I'd love to hear what your answer is. Kevin, how do I get stronger at doing pull-ups? Because that is a movement we use over and over in various forms, walls, monkey bars.
Yeah.
What's a basic series of workouts or exercise a person could do to get stronger for just grip strength obstacles?
Yeah, well, you're right. Pulling is the name of the game. So do more pulling movements. I think the biggest thing is overloading your body. In a race, we're just using our body weight. So maybe overstimulate by adding extra weight and going through those motions. That's the biggest thing. A lot of people do the calisthenics, which I think is great. But like, let's strap some weight around your waist.
Yeah.
Let's overload with some row movements. And then after you're fatigued, slap in some grip movements. A lot of times too, people are really good at doing some dead hanging and straight arm movements, but they're really bad about holding that like stagnant and isometric 90 degrees. And just working that solid flexion is super important.
Yeah, because you will get-
You just gotta work it. And negatives, get up and then just fight like heck on the way down. That's exactly simulating what's happening on the rig, monkey bars, things like that. So working those.
Okay.
Overload the muscle and work those negatives and some of those holds.
Awesome information.
Yep.
Hey, Kirk, great talking to you, man.
Hey, yeah,
thanks for coming by. Appreciate it.
Thank you.
Thanks for listening to the Spartan Athlete, the Friday edition of the Spartan Up podcast. Be sure to tune in next Friday where I talk to more athletes. We talk about racing, strategies, preparation, and getting you ready for a Spartan race. So get involved, subscribe, leave a comment, list on your favorite platform, and we'll see you next Friday.